Welcome to the show. I am Arkel Osteen, your hostess. Our guest is Mr. Mason Moses, Policy Specialist for Nacogdoches ISD. Welcome to the show, Mr. Moses.
So happy to be here.
Well, we're so happy to have you as a guest. Well, I understand that you've been working with some plans for NISD. Can you tell us a little about your plans and the action teams that are involved?
Absolutely. Now, as we, a few months ago, back in October, we started forming a strategic plan for Nacogdoches ISD. Now, basically, where are we going to go over the next 5 years? We have 30 various community members from across the city come together for a two-day-long retreat where we can develop 13 strategies and objectives to see how to make Nacogdoches ISD better. And those strategies have now become the basis for our action teams. And each action team is made up of about 7 to 10 community members, as well as school personnel. What they're tasked with is now coming up with a plan of how to implement these throughout the district. And that's the really, really exciting part that's going on right now. And so what they're doing right now is they're meeting about 4 to 5 times, and a lot of them already met at least 3 times, if not more, to further develop these plans. And this past week, we had a midpoint check-in to take the temperature of each group, and I'm really thrilled how they're progressing. They're really doing quite well, and I'm excited to see where this plan is going to take us. I'm excited to see the final product here in about a month. In about a month from now, or I guess late in April, early April, the plans will come together, and we'll take that to the strategic planning team. We'll then let the action teams know, and hey, you know what, you did really great, you hit the nail right on the head, or you did really good, but we need to tweak this one thing, or if they, hopefully not this happens, but it might, if they miss the ball, they'll go back to the drawing board and try and correct it, and then bring it back to the full strategic planning team.
Oh, you have so much going on, that is so neat. So when did you start on this?
We started back in October. We started about September. We started making the plans, but our first strategic planning meeting was in October. Yes, ma'am. And those plans and the strategic planning team came up with 6 areas to focus on.
6 areas.
Yes, ma'am. Came up with teaching and learning, which is a lot of curriculum based and technology services. Came up with HR personnel and personnel, so then with employment of district personnel, teachers, counselors, principals. You know, how can we attract them? How can we retain them? You know, how can we also make sure they have the resources they need to succeed? You know, funding and finances, we want to make sure that we are being good stewards of our taxpayers' dollars and, you know, being very mindful of that. You know, facilities, we want our children to be educated in facilities that are first class. We want them to, you know, be in places where they feel comfortable, they feel safe. Their parents feel good about dropping them off in the morning.
Sure.
And then another area focuses on communication.
And just making
sure that our community is involved, getting parents or the guardians involved, making sure that, now this is the district school.
Okay.
And we want to make sure that the district knows that. We want to make sure that they feel as if they are involved with the school system.
Sure.
That's very, very important. And there's just a few of the areas that they're working on, and we really are, you know, excited about the work that they're doing.
Oh, I'm sure that you are, and I'm excited too, just to hear about it. Now, when are these plans supposed to be put into place, all of the action plans?
They're going to be rolled out over the course of the next 3 to 5 years. Starting with next school year.
Next school year.
Mm-hmm.
And I've heard about some of the magnet schools.
Yes, ma'am.
Are those schools a part of the plan?
To an extent they are, but they're really more standing alone, like by themselves.
Okay.
But, I mean, if you're in the next 3 to 5 years, how can you not feel good about the magnet schools,
right,
and the great things that are going on with those? And so they're a part of this, but they're also a little bit mainly by themselves.
By themselves, I see.
Mm-hmm.
So are you going to start with the high school with some of the plans?
These are district-wide.
District-wide.
And as you can tell, I talked about, they talk everything from curriculum,
mm-hmm,
to personnel, to facilities and planning, you know, funding, communicating throughout the district. So that's going to be up to the leadership of the district, you know, the superintendent, the school board, to get together and say, no, we want to make this one a priority, or this is going to be a different priority. And so we want to, and so they're going to set out how we're going to, you know, whether it be parent involvement or we want to focus on curriculum, they're going to be involved in establishing what how we're going to roll these out over the next 3 to 5 years.
Okay, well, that sounds like a great plan that you all have and that you've been working on. Now, you mentioned that you have several community people working along on each action team. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Well, that's good. And I know you will be getting some great input from those community people.
By the time this is all said and done, we're going to have close to about 180 community members involved with this plan.
180.
Just about that number. And we can always use more. And so if people are interested, they can come up here and talk to me or someone else in the administration, we can get you involved. It's never too late to get involved with any of these action teams.
Okay. So how often do you meet?
That's up to the individual teams.
Oh, it's up to the team.
We're so blessed to have all the community input, but we also know that people have a lot going on in their lives. Uh-huh. And so it's up to the individual teams to meet as they see fit and feel, make sure they can get as much input as they can. So that's at their own discretion.
Okay. All right. No set dates, and it's just up to the team.
That's up to the individual teams. The only thing is that the next strategic planning team of the core 30 who started this, that's going to be April 1st, and that's going to be when the action teams come and they give their final presentations to the strategic planning team.
April 1st.
Yes, ma'am.
And that will be here?
It's going to be at Lanana Creek Hall.
Oh, Lanana Creek Hall.
Yes, ma'am.
So is it open to the community or to the public?
The final presentation, there'll be one to the school board.
To the school board.
This is, it's more of a, kind of like a dress rehearsal, if you will.
Okay.
So it's going to be to the strategic planning team to make sure that we have everything right before it's presented and put out for the public. But all those information is available online. There's a strategic planning link online. You can go and click on that little button. It takes you and shows you everything that we've worked on so far and everything that's been completed up to this point.
Oh, great. So you can go on the NISD and just look for that little link?
Yes, ma'am. Right there on the homepage, there's a little button that says strategic planning. Just click on that. Takes you, and you can just see, click on that. There's various documents out there that we've worked on and completed that you can see the progress that we're making.
All right. Now, if someone wanted to get involved, would they call your office?
Yes, ma'am.
They
can either come see me up at the District Support Center or give me a call. 569-5000 extension 8876, and we can get you involved. Like I said, the more the merrier, and we would love to have more community input because, like I said earlier, this is the school system belongs to the community. We want the school district to reflect what the community would like to see in it. So we would like the more input we can get, the better.
Oh, wonderful. Well, I'm so happy to hear about all those great things that you all are working on, and maybe I might get involved myself.
We'd love for you to.
Great, and thank you. Now, is there anything else you would like to share with us about the action teams or the plans?
Like I said before, we're just so blessed to have the members of those teams that are on there. They're doing great work. So if you talk to people out there in the community and they say they're a member of an action team, please say thank you because they're putting a lot of time and energy themselves to this, and this won't be successful without them.
Oh, yes.
And so thank you so much to everyone who's been a part of this so far and who will be a part of it in the future.
Oh, great. Well, I'll make sure I do that if I see some of them. And I'm so thankful that we have so many people involved with them and interested in the education of our students.
Absolutely.
Yes, and our school district also. Thank you so much for being a guest on the show, Mr. Moses. I really appreciate all of that valuable information.
My pleasure.
Sure. Thank you for joining us, and we will return in a few minutes.